Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nidja, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. One of our brother, Gordon, from Canada, he has asked me to render exposition of some saying of Jesus. So he writes, you know, that, hello, my name is Gordon. I'm watching some of your videos and I enjoy your understanding. I was wondering if you could help me with a parable. I think I understand it, but I would take your words over my own understanding. That's a good idea, you know, that's how you should learn. This is it. Jesus said, "This heaven will pass away, and the one above it will pass away." That means this heaven is, you know, the earth, you know, and one above is, you can see, say, which is, we talk about heaven, you know, whenever we talk about that God is up, because up means that is an honorable place. You know, on your head you put a turban, turban is honorable. So whenever we have somebody to honor, we put him over our head. So that's why I say, you know, that whatsoever happens, is that mean? The dead are not alive. The dead mean those people who read books, you know, book knowledge. You know, when these people read university professors, they read book knowledge, and they get drunk with the old wine of the letters. And when they are drunk with the old wine of the letters, they desireth not the new. So they don't want to know the new one. That's why when Christ Jesus was in Jerusalem, over there people are reading Torah. And they were talking about Christ will come in the house of David, this and that. And Jesus said, "What about the one standing in front of you?" They could not recognize him because they were dead. So the dead won't become living, you know. They are dead and they will remain dead. As in Jesus performed the miracles. For example, that of Lazarus, making him alive after 4 days. And when the news reached Jerusalem, then their temple priest told their congregation, "Never, don't mind him. Don't believe in him what they say. He is a magician. And just, you know, ignore him." And those who were dead in spirit, they just ignored him. They did not, they did what their rabbi or what their temple priest told them. As if the Pope says something, and those who are followers of Pope, men mean blind people, dead in spirit, then they will do what Pope has told them to do. If Pope says something, they will just agree to him. The Pope say, "Oh, there are angels, there are this and that," they will agree without thinking, you know. So they are called dead people who are dead in spirit. They have no spiritual reasoning, or their third eye is closed. And those such people were many in Jerusalem. And the living will not die. Living are those who are men of spirit. They don't need the letters, old wine of the letters. The Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person and looked after him, he was a living one. Did he read Torah and all those books? No. Their laws, moral laws, are written over their hearts. Or in other words, they go by their conscience and not by the letters of the books. The rabbi and Sadducee passed by that wounded person. They went by the letters of the books. We don't know this man, who he is. So they had no compassion for a person. But this Samaritan man, when he found the man, he didn't ask him whether he's a Jew or a Gentile or where from he came. He just picked him up, looked after him. Such a person is called twice born, because he see the light of our Father in everyone. So in the days when you consumed what is dead, what is dead mean? You know, ego. You must consume your ego in order to become alive or living in spirit. So when you are born, you are a natural man. Natural man cannot understand the things of God. Natural man is a once born person. He only understands the laws of nature, which is tit for tat. If he hits you, you hit him back. So the natural man, when you have overpowered him, natural man is racist, you know, because he likes his own color, own family, and not everyone. As those Pharisees, Sadducees, when they passed the wounded person, when they found, hey, he's not one of us, why should we bother? So that is called a ego, a natural man, once born. So once you are once born, then you display ego and all that racist and all that bad things. But when you become twice born, then you are no more discriminatory. You treat everyone alike. In the days when you consume what is dead, that means when you have consumed your ego, you made it what is alive. That means you made it, you got the real self in God, which is spirit. So you became a person of spirit. So when you became a person of spirit, you became a living, and the living God is for the living people and not for the dead in books or dead in ego, as these Jews are. If you ask them something or if you talk with them, they don't bother to talk to you. They turn their back and they are stiff-necked that they have read the Torah, they have know this thing and that thing. What these other people know, they hate them, you know, that they don't know. But when I tell them that you are bundled up for final burning, then and only then they turn around and like to talk with me. Otherwise, they don't bother. So when you come to dwell in the light, that means when you have become a twice-born person and you are imbued with the light of Christ or light of our Father, what will you do? So what will you do? You will earn his treasures. When you are in light, only then you can do the work of our Father. If you are in the darkness, then you cannot, because you don't know which, what is right and what is wrong. It is only in the light you can see what is right and what is wrong. Remember that when Peter went in fishing at night, there was no light, and he fished. The whole night he was trying to catch fish, he could not get any. So in the morning, when Christ Jesus was standing over there at the shore, he told Peter, put your net on the right of the boat. That means at that time the light of Christ has appeared. And when the light of Christ appears, we don't put our nets on the wrong side or preach gospel to the wrong people. We don't throw pearls before swines, but to the right mean to the people who are rightful, who are desiring to know his word. We go and preach among them. Now, if I have this knowledge and I go to India to preach gospel, what I'm doing in the West, over there they are no customers, because they always think that when you do something, you should make money. But in God, you don't look for money. You look for to become one with God, with our Father. So in India, they are always looking for money. Knowledge is there, but they can't preach it there because it won't shine there. People won't appreciate. So it will appreciate only in the West. So West is the right place to put your net. That is right-hand side of the boat. So what will you do? We will fish, become the fishers of men. Men are those who are masters of their own destiny. Like the John 9, born blind person. When his eyes were opened, he wasn't asking his parents what I should tell them. He spoke from his own heart. And that is called a man. A person is called a woman when the person speaks what his rabbi tell him to speak. These rabbis have disciples. So these disciples will do what their rabbis tell them to do. And they are called women because they obey what their master tells them to do. They are not the masters of their own destiny, but they have given their life or given their leash. If we call ourselves dog, they have given their leash to the rabbi. Wherever the rabbi takes them, they go. As in Pope, you know, people have given their leashes to Pope. And whatever Pope tells them, they do it. They are the disciples of the Pope, blind disciples. Whereas we, when we work for our Father, we give our leash to our Father, ourselves. And wherever our Father tells us to go, or whatever He tells us to do. We are His laborers, workers. So our Father is our gardener, and we are grafted to the true vine, Christ Jesus. That is what we will do. We will get ourselves grafted to that true vine. On the day when you are one, when you are one with our Father, God, remember that the soul are emanated from our Father. The flesh is obtained from our mother. That makes us a whole person. So that's Jesus saying, on the day when you are one with the Father in the royal kingdom of God, you became two on birth. When you are born, then when you are a child, you don't know right or left, or what it is, then even still you are one. But when you become sensible, you know that, oh, this is what I should get, money, this and that. Then you get entangled in mammon. Then you become two. Then you love this world and love our Father. But when you become two, what will you do? So simple. We want to go back to our Father on death. So what will we do? We earn treasures for our Father. We have been sent into this world to earn treasures for our Father. Those treasures are the Samaritan man earned by picking up the wounded person and giving him treatment, which is called philanthropy. So philanthropy are the treasures. So if you are a truthful person, you have conscience, you are truthful, you are contented, then it clears your own self, own heart. It makes yourself clean, but you haven't earned anything. Earning comes when you do merciful deeds or of philanthropy. Jesus said, if somebody invites you and you invite him back, that is not good because you have repaid him. But invite those who cannot invite you back. That means feed the poor, which is philanthropy. That is earning treasures for our Father. That's why Jesus said, when I was hungry, you fed me. And all those, you know, the people of light, that's what they do. I was in Ghana 14 years, and over there, you know, they had the custom, if somebody is a hungry, a stranger, if he comes to your field and he pick up the fruit or food from there and eat and go, they won't say anything. They will be happy to see him do it, you know. Not like these people who are mammon infested. They will go and catch him and beat him. Why did you steal the fruit from my tree? So this is the thing, you know, we have to be as generous as the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person. I hope this saying makes some sense. And if you, Brother Gordon, has anything to say, please write to me. I will appreciate. Our Father God bless you.